Welcome to Logical Late. Today I'm making a super cool RGB gaming cooler for gaming laptop. So what we are waiting for? I'm Jim here with you. Let's make it. I'm using a damaged cooler to make it. So if you have a damaged cooler, so don't throw out. Even it have no fan. So what do you do? Don't worry. You need to buy high speed CPU cooling fan. You can use RGB cooling fan. I'm using two cooling fan for this. Then you need a RGB LED light. I'm using auto fading color for this. You can use remote control color changing light. So let's make the gaming cooler. First of all, I clean that damaged case. So what I'm doing now, I'm going to join the fan backside of the steel net by using screw. Make sure you have to put the back side of fan on the steel net. You need some screw like this. Now you need to make some holes for the joining the fan. I have already 3 drilled holes. After drilling the holes, put the screw and tighten it. Now I'm glue it for the better joining. Make sure the fan is turned okay without any trouble. And make sure it fit well in the case. So what I'm doing now, I'm just joining the LED light on the side of the case. Just like that. Glue the LED lights with very carefully. Open the jack circuit if removable. Now I'm checking the LED lights is okay. Then I'm soldering the fan and light into the USB circuit board. Make sure the USB jack inside white color plastic in the below. And grab the USB like my hand. This is the negative point, and this is the positive point, and this is the switch line. Now I'm soldering the one fan's negative to the one's USB's negative, and then join the second fan negative to the other's USB's negative. And taking the two positive and soldering in the switch line. After doing that, it looks like this. Now I'm soldering the light's negative to the USB's negative. Now I'm checking the fans and light for sharing everything is okay. You need a switch for the LED light. I'm just joining the switch right here beside another switch. So I'm gonna drill it. After drilling, I'm joining the switch. Connect the switch one's wire to the USB's positive and connect another wire to the LED's light. Now I'm put back the screw. Now you need a USB cable and a female jack. Connect the USB cable to the female jack. And now you need a 12-volt adapter. It's time to check the RGB gaming cooler. Oh my goodness, it's clearly turned on. The switches are working, everything is okay. It's looking so beautiful, right? So that's it. You can make it by your own gaming cooler from Damage Cooler for your gaming laptop. No need to buy a new one. You can restore your cooler pad under $5 only. Hope you like it. Give a thumbs up. You can leave a comment and get subscribed. See you later in the next video.